Good morning, Ephraim. My name's Autumn.
My name's Wyatt.
And today is Monday, February 10th. Please rise for a moment of silence and pledge to the flag.
The SAT test will be given at EHS on Saturday, March 14th. The deadline to sign up without a late fee is February 14th. Go to collegeboard.org to register today.
The items on the lost and found table are stacking up. Students, you have until Thursday, 2/13, to claim your items or they will be donated.
On Saturday, February 8th, 56 students participated in the high school science fair. Congrats to all who participated. All students rated in superior and excellent are eligible to participate in the North Museum Science Fair in March. Keep up the good work. In the superior category, Alyssa Fedorshak, Justin Pauser, Olivia Fedorshak, Joshua Potts, Chase Wilson, and Braden Ritter.
And in the excellent category, we have Ashley Mizaki, Meg McCracken, Caitlin Rice, Dayton Stauffer, Morgan Zimmerman, Shannon Slaughter, Kiara Parsons, Josiah Ebersole, Bryn Fry, Olivia Gordon, Celia
Camara,
thank you, Gianna Dreyer, Lennon Holtzapple, Nigel Martel, Madeline Fritz, Adam Gockley, Devin Robertson, Talia Schaefer, Lily Moore, Ezekiel Jones, Olivia Harrington, and Madison Stewart.
In the commencement category, we have Athena Castro, Bradley Malmer, Sophia Stauffer, James Ellis, Taylor Becker, Cody Brown, Austin Keynes, Jessica Pratt, Grace Young, Jonathan Petreka, Tunveen Bondal, Sarah Eberling, Thomas Petreka, Mia Goldberg, Amanda Gardner, Madison Geip, Anish Kadka, Alexandria Kowalski, and Julia Romanyatsev.
And in the satisfactory category, we have Alyssa Ween, Tyler Profeto, Haley Deemer, John Peace Bidding, and Ryan Lindberg and Oliver Fogarty Harnish. Now over to Riley with the news.
News! 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 It's news time, baby!
Director Bong Joon-ho's Parasite became the first non-English movie to win Best Picture on Sunday. The suspenseful South Korean film, which focuses on class distinction through the relationship of the Park and Kim families, also won the Oscar for Best International Feature Film, Best Original Screenplay, and Best Director. It has also been nominated for Best Production Design and Best Film Editing. On this day in history, Bob Dylan releases The Times They Are A-Changin', his third album in 1964 by Columbia Records. The album is seen as a protest album featuring songs about issues such as racism, poverty, and social change. The title track was one of Dylan's most famous, capturing the spirit of social and political upheaval that characterized the 1960s. Also, please stay in homeroom today. We're going to be going past the bell. Today's a doozy. It's a long one. Now over to the juniors with the lunch.
Well, good morning, Ephra. I am here with Jordan Lead.
Hi.
All right. Today, the 10th of February, we have chili cheese fries with garlic Texas toast.
Chicken parm sandwich.
Cheese crunchers.
BLT with cheese with whole grain toast.
Fruit and yogurt parfait with a freaking muffin.
Chief salad.
It says chef.
I know.
Wow. I see what you did there. French fries.
Steamed broccoli.
Fresh baby carrots or celery with dip.
Chilled peaches, fresh fruit, or slushy.
A slushy, baby.
Sports time,
boy!
Give me your attention, baby.
Good morning. Sports time. Friday and Saturday swimming competed in the LL League swim meet. The 200 medley relay team got fifth, Thomas McGillen got fourth, and Colby Symes got fifth in the 200 free. Chad Jones came in sixth, and Lucas Kopschneider got in seventh in the 200 medley individual medley, and Thomas McGillan got second in the 50 free. The 200 freestyle relay team got third. The 400 freestyle relay team of Thomas McGillan, Colby Symes, and Chad Jones, and Lucas Kopfschneider won a gold medal. Lucas also got second in the 500 freestyle. Chad Jones got sixth in the 100 breaststroke, and the boys team got third overall. On the girls' side, the medley relay team got eighth. The 200 freestyle relay team got fourth. Anya Emmerling got sixth in the 500 freestyle, and the girls got sixth in the 400 freestyle relay team, and seventh overall as a team. In rifle, three Ephrata shooters finished the season as league all-stars. Nicole Johnson finished second in the league with an average of 99.42. Brianna Bowers finished in third place in the league with an average of 99.33. And Sawyer Bull finished eighth in the league with an average of 99. Ephrata as a team finished the season second in the league with a record of 11 wins and 3 losses.
Yay! Woo! Good job.
Ephrata as a team finished second in the league tournament with a score of 989 and 11 centers.
Solid.
Two Ephrata shooters finished in the top 10 in the league individuals tournament. Jonathan Petreka finished fourth with a score of 199 and 2 centers, and Nicole Johnson finished 10th with a score of 198 and 4 centers. And finally, a correction has been made with the results of the pairs tournament from last week. Lauren Zimmerman and Christopher Manuel finished second instead of third in the B division after it was discovered that the original second place team was actually an A division team. This announcement is for anybody looking to have a good time. On February 21st and 22nd, the 2020 Ephrata Wiffle Ball and Cornhole Tournament will be taking place at the Ephrata Middle School. Funny team names and crazy uniforms are the name of the game, and this year we decided to add a Cornhole Tournament. Refreshments and silent auctions you won't want to miss will be available in the foyer. Wiffle Ball teams are $100 and Cornhole teams are $40, with a portion of the proceeds being donated to Ovations for the Cure of Ovarian Cancer. Please visit MountsHardball.com and click on the Wiffle Ball Tournament tab for more information. Now back to the main desk!
The Epic Book Drive is Friday, February 13th. The signups continue through today. You can sign up during lunches. Be sure to come show your love for the local piranhas the day before Valentine's Day.
Attention, all high school students. Ephrata Minithon is holding their annual Sadie's Dance. The dance will be held February 15th from 7 to 10 p.m. in the high school gym. Tickets will be sold at all lunches from February 10th to the 13th for $8 or at the door for $10. You may bring a student from another school. However, you must fill out a guest permission form and meet all the guidelines and regulations. These forms will be in a folder next to Minithon's announcement bulletin board and can be handed in when purchasing your ticket. Come out and enjoy a fun night with your friends. We hope to see you there. If you have any questions, please see Mr. Martin or Mrs. Sosi.
The countdown begins. Ephrata Minithon main event is February 29th, 2020 from 2 to 10 in the middle school gym. The theme this year is jungle. Registration instructions are hanging in a folder next to the Minithon bulletin board. The cost this year is a minimum of $35 for a shirt and $25 without a shirt. To guarantee a shirt, payment and registration must be done by February 14th, which is this Friday. New this year, you are allowed to bring students from other schools as well as EHS graduates from the 2019 class. To do this, you need to pick up and fill out a guest form. You can find this guest form online in the office and at the Minithon bulletin board. Your guest must also pay the fee. If you have any questions, please contact Mrs. Sosi, Mr. Martin, or a Minithon member. We hope to see all of you there.
Attention all high school students, the Ephrata Minithon is holding a student faculty basketball game on February 26th at 7 p.m. During this game, the senior girls and boys will be competing against EHS teachers, faculty, and staff members. New this year, we will be selling the PA Farm Show milkshakes before and after the game. We will also be having a raffle before the game for adults and students to be able to shoot from the half court and gain points for the teachers and students score. We hope to see you all there. Have a not bad, Ephrata. Have a not bad.
Bye.
We love you.
Have a not bad.